pay and dismay, Brighton and Hove City Council receives millions from parking charges to make it into the top 10 local authorities for its parking profits in the whole of the country. £11 million was made last year from ticket machines like this one to on-the-spot fines. The ranking came ahead of a new report suggesting Brighton is one of five best places for being carless because of its public transport and cycling alternatives. The price to park on pay and display machines like this one on Brighton's Madeira Drive ranged from £1 for just 1 hour up to £7 for 11 hours, with prices fluctuating between winter and summer. But the people in Brighton pulling up to park think the price is right.
Yes, I think it is quite expensive, and I think it's hard to find a space. I've just arrived, I spent half an hour looking for a space, I finally found one and it was £5, and I think that's too much. And I think it's bad for the local traders too.
£1 an hour is what we're probably used to, really. Unless you go to York, and then you need a second mortgage to be able to park in York.
Yeah.
It's phenomenally expensive.
I think it is quite expensive for what it is, but Brighton's a small city with limited parking, so I'm not surprised that it's expensive.
Although some people see it as a cash cow for the local authority, the money is reinvested in parking and public transport, £14 million to be precise. In a statement, Brighton and Hove City Council said, "The council doesn't make a profit from parking because it all goes straight out again, mainly spent on vital travel provision for older and disabled people. Charges also pay for parking enforcement, which help ensure scarce parking space is used fairly, keeps people safe and the traffic moving." Whether or not you feel happy to part with your cash at the city's pay and display machines, the money is making the rest of the city move. And with more and more people seemingly ditching four wheels for two or even a double-decker bus, it seems people are being turned away from pay and display. This is James Dunham for Latest TV News.